Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that systemctl, okay, the latest version of systemd, we are going to see that. So basically in RSCL 7, what are the major change is that in RSCL 7, they have replaced the traditional SysV system, the init system, with the systemd, so which is a major replacement for the new version of the Linux, so where you can control a number of things. Or here the systemctl is divided into the different unit files. So that units in systemd, the target of most actions are units, which are resources that systemd knows how to manage. Units are categorized by the types of resources they represent, and they are defined with files known as unit files. The type of each unit can be interfered from the suffix on the end of the file. So let me see that, so what it shows. Okay, so let me switch back to the root user, because I don't want to type sudo all the times, so just I would like to continue with this. Let's see over here, so how that system units can be shown, or how the system units can be specified. So basically the systemctl command, the syntax is over here. So here systemctl is the command you have to specify, and here what is the action you would like to do. So the action, which in sense you want to do a status, or you want to do a restart, or you want to do a reload, or you want just wanted to see the related stuff on that service, all the stuff. And here you can specify that whatever the name, the service name, okay, and its unit name. So like this, service name, its unit name. The unit name can be service.service, or socket, or device name, or mount name, or auto mount name, or swap name, target, or path, timer, slice, scope. There are a number of unit files are there in that which you wanted to start. Example is that you wanted to start only the service, then service name dot unit name is service. Or if you want to start some sockets on that service, the socket name on that service name dot that socket you have to define. So the unit name can be a service, socket, device, mount, auto mount, swap, target, path, timer, slice, and scope. So these are the units available on the systemctl service. So whatever the name you would like to, most of the situations we use a dot service, okay, most of the situations we use dot service or dot mount names, something like that. But these are the you can use to be on this systemctl unit names. You can use anything what is your requirement upon. So for service management task, the target unit will be service units, which have unit files with a suffix. The suffix is dot service or dot socket, dot device, or whatever it is. However, for most service management commands, you can actually leave off the dot service suffix, which means that so you can simply leave dot service for most of the services you wanted to restart or check the status, or you wanted to show them the details about that service, which process it's using, all the related stuff, you can do that. So let's go ahead and see some examples over here. Just I would like to see that status of network dot service. So this is the exact the status output will be. In this status output, it gives you a detailed information that if the service is running successfully or not. Okay, the service is whether it is enabled, which means that while restarting your system, whether it is enabled or not. Okay, which process ID it is exactly using, and which exactly the path of that service file, where it is located, the script to start that service, and what is this listening on, and all the details about that can be given on this service status, which means that the system CTL status on this any service. If you take example, say that system CTL status, I would like to see that SSHD status. So the similar output you will get for everything, which means that which is the domain it is used, and which exactly the path, the file path is going to be loaded over here, and whether it is enabled to start on the, whenever you restart, whether it is enabled to start on the startup process or not. If it is enabled, which means that your service is enabled to start on the startup whenever you reboot the machine. Okay, so this is the daemon name. So related docs, if you want to find some related documentation about that SSH related, you can use these commands to do some documentation stuff over here, and which PID currently which is using, and which shared process are CG groups. Okay, the which actually the complete units is made as into the groups. So one service can be run into the multiple group related information over here. So it will give you the all the details, like which is running and what is the status of it, which port it is used listening on, okay, whether it is accepting all the socket numbers or not, all the details it will give you over there. It's going to be give you. So if you would like to verify that in a single line, that whether the service is active or inactive, or whether it is enabled or not enabled, you can simply type that system CTL is active and provide the service name with unit name, so that it say that okay, the service is active. Whether it is enabled to start on startup, you can say that is it enabled. You say that is it enabled. So like that you can verify any other services if you would like to get the status over here like this. So whether it is active, maybe you can get the different outputs, like it is masked or it is the stopped or not stopped, activated, not activated. Okay, those are the information you will get on the active status information. So if you'd like to enable any service to start on startup, you can simply use that system CTL enable and service name dot unit name, cronty dot service. Just I would like to say that is it enabled? Yes, it is enabled. If you'd like to restart, maybe, so if you'd like to restart these services, you can simply use that instead of enable, you can simply say that restart over here. The service will be restarted, but you will not get any output over here. You have to verify the status so that it will give you the detailed information about that, whether the service is restarted properly or not, when it is started. So all the details over here. If you would like to reload, example say that what the difference between the restart and the reload. So the reload, in the sense, it's affect the services changes, what are the changes you have changed on that service will be affected, but the existing PID will never change if you reload the service. So a similar way, you can see that the PID is 2563. If I would like to reload this system CTL service, example say that reload over here, say crond.service. So if you go and verify the status again, see this 2563 is the same ID before and now. So that's what happens when the restart and reload is the differentiation there. So reload, in the sense, what are the configuration changes without interrupting the service, you can apply to the service, but if you restart it, get interrupted and it's get reloaded completely, what are the services, what are the existing PIDs will be killed off and it will be start the new PIDs over here. If you'd like to verify that what are the dependencies that service has, you can simply see that systemctl list dependencies. List dependencies and provide the name of the service which you would like to verify over here. Then it will give you that what are the, how many dependencies are there for that. See this, how many dependencies are there over here. So like this you can verify the dependencies and you can verify the system units as well. List units. So these are all the units which is going to be activated or the active currently running, all this information over here. See this, this many units are currently there on the system. So there are more than that actually. See this, there are device units and there are some different units over here. See this, most of the units are services and you can also see some mounts and you can also see some path. Okay, maybe you can also see some different see this swap and targets, all this socket also you can see over here. Like this, there are different units. You can simply see that, okay, these are the status. You can also see that what is mean by the load and active and sub, all this information you can see over here. So if you'd like to see that unit files, example say that list all the unit files which are currently running or not running, enabled or not enabled, all the information can be shown over here. You can see this, see this. Or if you can also be filtered further, if you'd like to show only the enabled one or disabled one, something like that, you can also filter over here. Okay, maybe the filter can be applied further. Maybe you can also use some grep if you'd like to see only the enabled services over here. You can see that this many services got enabled, which is going to be very very easy to identify the service status, and you can do that. So that here in the systemctl you can also set a default targets. Default target in the sense which mode you would like to boot. Example say that you would like to boot into the multi-user target or the emergency mode or whatever the mode you would like to mode. Example say CLI or GUI or what are this does you wanted to set, you can do that as well. Example say that systemctl get default. Example say that what is the default target currently I have. So this is the target currently I have. If you would like to set a different target, you can also use systemctl and set default, say that multi-user dot target. Just I would like to set this multi-user dot target so that whenever I reboot the machine, it's going to be in a CLI mode. Or if I would like to change this back again to the graphical user mode, you can use that graphical so that you can get this information over here. So this is how you can change your set default values. So these are the targets you have currently. So you can set any number of target to boot your system into that target. Currently I am using this graphical dot target so that whenever my system is booted, it's going to be run into the graphical mode. You can see this is the graphical mode. If you set into the multi-user mode, it's going to be a CLI mode. Okay, so whatever you wanted to set, you can set it. But most of the users is familiar or used to see that the graphical mode, so that the basic users can also be happy that whenever they see that GUI instead of CLI. So that's what I can set it up by default into the graphical mode. That would be a great, or that would be a useful for you to set up. So but here in systemctl they have the different concept called a masking. What does mean by the masking the services? Masking the services in the sense, whenever you say that you stop the service or you disable the service, but the other user can other user can able to enable the service and start the service. But if you mask the service, they cannot enable or they cannot start the service until unless they unmask the service. So let's see over here, example say that systemctl, I would like to disable cron.d service over here. So it's going to be disabled, and I'm going to verify that systemctl is enabled cron.service. You can see that the system is going to be the cron.d is disabled. So I would like to say that it's going to be stop. So I stop the service, and I'm just going to see the systemctl status cron.d.service, which says that which is inactive and died, which is disabled mode. So still I can see that some of the schedulers or the some of the commands are still trying to stop its related services. Okay, if you would like to mask the service now, mask. So now what you can do, that if you would like to start the service, just see this status over here, so which is masked. You can see that which is masked. If you would like to start the service and try over here, what happens? See this, fail to start cron.d, unit is masked. So the whenever you masked it, so nobody can start the service or enable the service, or they cannot do anything until unless they unmask this. Unmask, now you can start the service. You can see that is our status. You can see that it is running and active. Like that, you can verify, you can mask the service whenever you don't need the service, or you don't want it to stop whenever the service system is restarted, or you can tell the other administrators or the other users that do not start the service until unless they have the continuous requirement on that service to start. So this is you can do to the all the services which are not required or which you don't wanted to start the service. So that makes a lot of resources saving of your hardware resources, or it can also be save your system from the unauthorized access using those services, or security compromisation, all this so that will enable you to make more secure of your system. So this is about the systemctl, guys. You can also use the systemctl command to power off your machine or reboot your machine. Okay, even you can do this halt your system. So this is how you can do that. Example say that I would like to reboot this machine. So you can do that simply, the system is going to be rebooted, or you can also power off using this systemctl command. So forget about the service RIN 81 2 3 4 5, something like that. Make use of systemctl so that you will be perfect. And please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.